Hi guys, this is a video about the working of direct online starter or DOL starter. We can see in the figure, it's a pictorial representation of how the line diagram or circuit diagram. So here you can see the main bus bar, or I will be represented by RYB. So from the main bus bar, the supply will be coming over here till here, and here we have got an isolating switch. It's like an MCB, it will be normally closed. I mean, when we are at home, we are actually starting this motor by using just a start push button or stopping by stop push button. So this will be normally closed. I will draw it in closed position. It's like an MCB. If you close the MCB, it will be in closed position. So the supply from the main bus bar, RYB, that will be coming till here. So because it's open over here, so it will be coming till here from R, from Y, as well as from B. And here we have got a fuse. Fuse is actually, as you know, like if there is an overcurrent or something, so that time it will melt down and stop the supply. So anyway, that's what the supply has reached till here. So here, and we have got a transformer here. This transformer is actually for this DOL starter to work. The system require a DC supply and a small voltage DC supply. For that purpose, we have to take some of the supply from the main bus bar and to convert and give to the this thing, DOL starter, because here you can see a closing coil here. In order to energize this closing coil, we require around 24 volt DC supply. So for that purpose, what we are using, this transformer will take, you know, it's like for example, if a three-phase, so 440 AC supply, transformer will step down this to smaller voltage, and by using a rectifier, it is converted into DC. So for example, I will write it 24 voltage DC. So this will be the output from this transformer and rectifier, and here also it is written low voltage operating supply. So this supply will be coming, okay, this is for operating the DOL starter. So the supply will be coming over here, and till here this is also closed, and closing coil is there, and it will be coming over here till here, and the other end it's also coming through the fuse. Stop button, this is normally closed position, and will be coming over here. Now this circuit, from the transformer, this DC supply, this circuit is not closed, it's open, and it will close only when this is the only portion it is open, right? Rest everywhere it is closed. So this will close only when I push the start button, okay? So that time this will close, and it can make a path over here, and it can go back to here, right? So this will be the line like this. This can go like that, okay? It is forming a closed circuit. So now we are going to start the motor. So that time what we are doing, it's actually spring loaded. That means when you push the start button, that moment it makes the contact close, and when you leave it, that time it's opening. Actually the circuit is getting open. So when you push the start button, the circuit is getting close, because this was the only place it was open. The circuit is getting close, and current will be passing through here, and through the closing coil it will be coming back to here. So now this closing coil got current because the circuit got closed. So this closing coil get energized. So when it get energized, this linkage, you can see the linkage, this is actually the main contact. This will cause the main contact to close. So this will cause this linkage to move on the left side, or to engage to the main contacts. So at that time, this switch S, this contact, or switch, not, it's a contact. So this contact also getting close, this also getting close, this also getting close, this also getting close. So when the coil get energized, this main contacts getting close. So what happened from the bus bar here, also the direct connection from the bus bar, it was coming till here because of this coil was open before. That was the only reason the supply was not coming to the motor. Now this main contacts are also closed, so the supply will be directly coming to the motor, and motor will be starting, right? Motor will be running. So at the same time, we should also know that here I have to mention one more thing. Here, when we push the start button, that is just a momentary thing, because we are not pushing and keeping it over there, because we are leaving our fingers that moment this is opening, right? So But even if it's open, the supply which has come when you just pushed or when it made close the contact, that time here it is closed and the coil also get energized. That moment when it closed, that time this was also getting close. This contact was also getting close. So it form another path. Instead of this path, when you push the start button, at that time itself it has formed another path to flow the current, so that the current will continuously flow and this coil will remain in energized position, and this contact also will remain in the closed position, and motor will be getting current from the bus bar. So that is the purpose of this closing coil. So now it started. When you wanted to stop, you just pushing the stop button. This is also spring loaded. Okay, so when you push the stop button, this will open, but it will come back at the same time. So when it open, no supply is coming, so nothing will go through either of this path or this path. So this entire system that will remain open because nothing is coming here. Before, when it was starting, this was closed, and after, I mean, at that starting moment, then it also got closed. Now current is coming, so this both, no current is coming to here, so this will, the closing coil will not get any current, and this will de-energize the coil and cause the this linkage to open, or the main contact to open, so no power will be available to the motor to start the motor. So that's what happens when you push the stop button. So now sometime you may think that why we are actually using this dual starter, because it's doing actually nothing, it's just starting and stopping. Instead we could even use a switch, normal switch, because that also do the same purpose. But the difference is that, like, for example, in our home we start the motor by using this push button. Suppose we just having a switch to start the motor. So we started the motor, and after some time power failure has occurred. So power has failed, and after 5 minutes power has come back, but that time the motor will again start because the switch was closed. So when power was not there, motor got stopped, and when power has come back, motor gets started. So that happens when if there is a switch. But when we are having a dual starter, that time, see, even the power was there when we started. First we started the motor, power was there, it was starting, running, and when power failure has come, there is no current to the bus bar, and also there is no current to the transformer or nothing to energize the coil. This will remain open, and even the power has come, closing coil is not energized, because here the circuit is open. This will only close when you push the start button. That means even if the power comes back, the motor will not start unless you put the start button. That means that is an advantage, like it's like a safety. Like you started the motor, and after some time power failure has come, and again power has come, that time it will not automatically start the motor. Or if sometimes power comes and go back very, like every alternate minutes power is coming and going back. So if that happens, the motor will be starting and stopping again and again several times. That's not good for the motor. It also draw more current for starting current. So that kind of problem will not happen if we have a dual starter, and that's actually make the difference with the dual starter and the switch. Another thing, I told, this is only used for a motor having less than 5 HP, because here we are not reducing the starting current or anything. If we having more power, then we should have other kind of starters, like star delta starter or auto transformer starter, in order to reduce the starting current. But here it's okay. This starting current can be drawn from the supply. So that is one thing. And another advantage, like here we have got safety trip. This is like if there is overcurrent, like this can be even written as overcurrent. Like if there is an overcurrent drawing, so if something happens to the motor winding, if that got short circuited or more current is drawing, that time this safety trip, this will get trip. This trip will get tripped, and this will also, when it gets tripped, it's also connected to this DC supply. This one also here. This will also open. So when it's open, no supply will be coming to the closing coil. So this closing coil also will get de-energized, and it will also open. So no power or supply will be coming. This will also open. This is a safety trip already activated, and this supply will also open, because here the supply will be open. So closing coil will de-energize and supply will open, so no current will be coming to the motor. So that's it, that's how the dual shutter works. That's the principle, and this is explanation with this diagram. I hope you understood, and if you liked the video, please click the like button and subscribe the video. Thank you.